It was like watching Gutenberg at the printing press, Edison change a light bulb, or Henry Ford tune up a Model T. The only difference was, with Les Paul, you could watch him tinker with his invention. Every Monday night for 23 years, the man who invented the solid body electric guitar played a couple of sets in a New York City nightclub.
I get out of bed just because of Mondays, you know. Love to play, love to entertain, love to make people laugh, make them happy.
When we met Les Paul 7 years ago.
You've got it all here, don't you? A life's work.
His home in New Jersey looked like a wing of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, crammed with long-forgotten artifacts and long-faded memories.
Well, this happens to be one of my very favorite guitars, and this one made probably more of our hits than any other guitar.
Born in 1915 in Waukesha, Wisconsin, Les Paul got his first guitar when he was 9, a $3.98 mail order model from Sears Roebuck.
I took this thing out of the package, out of the box, and it accidentally played a string. You know, it stuck to the hook of one of the staples, whatever, and it made a note like that. Mother come in, she says, "You're great already."
By age 12, he was playing around town with a nickname straight from Tin Pan Alley, Red Hot Red. He headed to Chicago in the late 20s as the jazz age hit its stride. His first steady gig was with Fred Waring and the Pennsylvanians, but his first hit didn't come until he teamed up with a silky crooner in 1945.
Kiss me once, then kiss me twice, then kiss me once again.
Bing Crosby.
It's been a long, long time.
You know, Bing calls up and says, "Hey, Les, tomorrow you want to record with me?" And I says, "Sure, what time?" He says, 8. I says, 8 at night? He says, "No, 8 in the morning." Nobody records at 8 in the morning. He says, "My voice is better." He says, "When I first wake up, it's lower, you know."
But to Les, the most important collaboration of 1945 was with Mary Ford. She became the voice of his melodies and the love of his life.
The stars belong to everyone. They gleam there for you and me.
Let me ask you about Mary.
Mm-hmm.
I've read some of your quotes. You love like that once.
Yeah.
What was she like?
Mary was probably, not was, she has more talent than any person I've ever seen in my lifetime. Now there is a gal that was gifted. And I miss Mary. Yeah.
Les Paul and Mary Ford were married in 1949. Between 1950 and 57, they had 28 hit records, including their signature song, "How High the Moon."
Until you will steal my heart, how high the moon.
Though their marriage would later hit a sour note and they would go their separate ways, Les Paul and Mary Ford were pop music's first royal couple.
A husband and wife musical team and two of the most popular names in the record business. Mary, what songs do you particularly like to sing?
Well, I like to sing them all, Ed, but I just would like to sing them like Les would like me to sing them.
Uh-huh. He cracks the whip, does he?
Well, no, but I love him.
Good as he was as a performer, to understand the genius of Les Paul, the reason Gutenberg or Edison is no exaggeration, you have to look at Les Paul the inventor, who tinkered in his basement and ended up rocking the world.
Well, this is probably the proudest thing of all. And this here.
This block of wood?
This block of wood.
Is the proudest thing.
That is the key to the whole thing.
He called it the log. The key to the whole thing, as he said, because it was his first attempt at a new type of guitar, the solid body electric.
You've got a pickup
from a telephone. That's it.
A door hinge, a string, and a block of wood.
That's it. There it is.
This is like the printing press or the Model T?
It's the beginning. Another 10 years, and I was well on my way with the electric guitar.
He went to M.H. Berlin, who was then the chairman of our company, and tried to talk him into manufacturing a solid body Les Paul guitar. And initially, Gibson wasn't interested.
Henry Juskowitz is the CEO of the Gibson Guitar Company, one of the premier guitar makers in the world.
Most of our guitars were large bodies and were hollow. Les Paul was a solid piece of wood, and it was smaller. It was a very radical new look, if you will.
He finally convinced the company his idea was the shape of things to come, and in 1952, Gibson rolled out its first Les Paul. Rock and roll never looked back. By the late 60s and early 70s, most of rock's star guitarists were devoted to the versatility of the Les Paul guitar. Pete Townsend of The Who, Jimmy Page of Led Zeppelin, Keith Richards of the Rolling Stones, the Eagles' lead guitarist, Joe Walsh.
He was so far ahead of his time.
Walsh plays and collects Gibson Les Pauls. A vintage model like this one from 1958 is worth a small fortune.
At least $30,000.
Really?
Yeah. And the sky's the limit from there. It's a great, comfortable guitar. It's balanced, perfect. And really, nobody's been able to top this basic design that he came up with screwing around in his shop.
These days, when music fans hear the name Les Paul, they're more likely to think of a guitar than a musician. And that was always just fine with the man himself, as long as he had his Monday nights to tinker.
Just be able to put my name on an idea and have it come true. It is, there's a lot of dreams come true in my lifetime. Yeah, very grateful.